Hi, this is Dr. Swikot Majumdar. Today we will discuss wave particle duality. This is under the module of quantum mechanics. Learning objective is to acquire the knowledge of matter wave. Wave particle duality actually the phenomena like photoelectric effect, Compton effect, or the emission of energy from hot body cavity, all those phenomena are explained on the basis of quantum theory of radiation. According to quantum theory of radiation, an electromagnetic radiation behaves like quanta or photon like particle of relativistic mass h nu by c square. Velocity is c and momentum is h nu by c. But the photon theory failed to explain the phenomenon of interference or diffraction, etc. Actually, light can exhibit both kind of nature of waves and particles. So light shows wave particle dual nature. The phenomenon interference, diffraction, polarization, it behaves as wave-like. In other cases, like photoelectric, Compton effect, it behaves as particles. Thus, we can conclude that light and other electromagnetic radiations sometimes act like waves and sometimes like particles or photons. So, light has a dual nature. It behaves like a wave in time of transmission and as a particle when it interacts with the matter. Now, this is the picture of Louis de Broglie. De Broglie proposed the matter wave. Matter evidently has particle properties. Therefore, by analogy with radiation particles should be expected to show wave-like properties. In 1924, de Broglie suggested, as a French theoretical physicist, that material properties behave like waves on some occasions, and it was experimentally verified by Davis and Germer in 1927 by electron diffraction from nickel crystal. This figure suggests that electron is revolving round the nucleus and radius of the orbit is a, and it is producing wavelength of lambda. Now, de Broglie proposed that a wave is always associated with every moving particle like electron, and its corresponding wavelength called de Broglie wavelength and is given by lambda is equal to h by p, where p is the momentum, h is the Planck's constant, mv represents momentum. De Broglie waves. Not only the light, but every materialistic particle, such as electron, proton, or even the heavier object, exhibits wave-like dual nature. De Broglie proposed that moving particle, whatever its nature, has waves associated with it. These waves are called matter waves. The energy of the photon is E is equal to h nu, where h is the Planck's constant. Its value is 6.624 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. Nu is the frequency of radiation. For a particle, a photon of mass m, so energy becomes E is equal to mc square as per Einstein's mass energy relation. So E is equal to mc square and E is equal to h nu, equating these two, mc square is equal to h nu. So nu is equal to c by lambda. We can write, cancelling out this c, lambda is equal to h by mc. Suppose a particle of mass m is moving with velocity v, then the wavelength associated with it can be given by lambda is equal to, this will change, lambda is equal to h by mv. This is h by mv, or lambda is equal to h by p. That is already I have discussed. Now, if v tends to 0, lambda tends to infinity, which means that v tending to infinity means the denominator will be 0. Sorry, v tends to 0 means the denominator will be 0, so lambda becomes infinity. It means that the waves are associated with moving particles only. The waves are associated with moving particles only. V0 means lambda is equal to infinity. That the waves are associated with moving particles, moving material particles only. De Broglie waves does not depend on whether the moving particle is charged or uncharged. It means matter waves are not electromagnetic in nature. This point to be remembered, de Broglie wave does not depend on whether the moving particle is charged or uncharged. That means matter waves are not electromagnetic in nature. Proof of de Broglie equation. Let us consider the case of a photon with its mass m and rest mass is m0. According to Planck's quantum theory, the relation between E, that is the energy of a photon, and frequency nu of the associated wave is given by E is equal to h nu. Now, for a relativistic particle, the square of relativistic energy is E square is equal to P square C square plus M0 square C to the power 4, where C is the velocity of light. Or E square is equal to P square C square, as the photon with rest mass M0 is equal to 0. So E becomes PC. So we can write E is equal to PC is equal to H nu, or P is equal to H nu by C. Thus P is equal to nu by C means 1 by lambda. So P is equal to H by lambda. So lambda is equal to H by P. This is the de Broglie's formula. When a charged particle subjected to potential V, then E is equal to, suppose the particle is moving with velocity v, E is equal to half mv square. So this energy that is impacted on E is equal to qv. So E is equal to half mv square is equal to qv. Now lambda is equal to h by p, is equal to root over h by root over 2mv, because this one is multiplied by this 2, to E is equal to mv square. So m square v square means 2me, mv means root over 2me. So lambda is equal to h by p means h by mv means h by root over m, replacing mv by root over 2me. So h by root over 2me. Now E is equal to q into v, that is a charged particle having charge q is subjected to the potential v. So h by root over 2m qv. For electron, put in the values of h, mass of the electron and charge of the electron, we can find lambda electron is equal to 12.27 root over v angstrom. For lambda proton, 0.286 by root over v angstrom. Lambda deuteron and lambda alpha particle are this. This is the given values. At temperature T, the de Broglie wavelength can be written in this form. Lambda is equal to h by root over 3m by kT. Now E is equal to energy per degrees of freedom is 3 by 2 kT. Now putting this value of energy, h lambda is equal to h by root over 2m, E means 3 by 2 kT. This 2 cancel out. This one becomes 3m kT. For thermal neutron, thermal electron, we can find out the wavelength. Wave velocity or phase velocity. When a monochromatic wave travels through a medium, its velocity of advancement in the medium is called wave velocity or phase velocity. We can represent Vp is equal to omega by k, where omega is equal to 2 pi nu. Nu is the frequency, omega is known as the angular frequency. K is the wave number or propagation constant, is equal to 2 pi by lambda, while lambda is the wavelength. In this picture, so envelope represents the wave velocity, and inner one is representing the group velocity that we will discuss in just later on. Group velocity. In practice, we came across pulses rather than monochromatic waves. A pulse consists of a number of waves differing slightly from one another in frequency. The observed velocity is, however, velocity with which the maximum amplitude of the group advances in a medium. So, the group velocity is the velocity with which the energy of the group is transmitted. We will represent it as V suffix G. The individual waves travels inside the group with their phase velocities. Vg is equal to d omega by dk. Vp was omega by k, but Vg is d omega by dk. Relation between phase and group velocity. Now, Vg is equal to d omega by dk. We can write omega is Vp means omega by k. So, omega is equal to k into Vp in this equation. Here, omega means k into Vp. Putting this here, k Vp. This is k Vp. So, this is becomes Vg is equal to first one d by dk. This is Vp plus k dVp by dk. Now, k means 2 pi by lambda, dVp by d, 2 pi by lambda. This becomes Vg plus Vp. 2 pi will cancel out. D by d lambda, that means this is d by 1 by d, 1 of lambda. So, Vg plus Vp plus 1 by lambda, dVp minus, after differentiating, minus 1 by lambda square d lambda. So, Vg is equal to Vp minus lambda dVp by d lambda. In a dispersive medium, Vp depends on frequency. In a dispersive medium, Vp depends on frequency. That is, omega by k not equal to constant. So lambda dvp by d lambda is positive. Not always, it is positive. So if it is positive, then this vp value will be reduced by this quantity. So vg will be less than vp. So in dispersive medium, vg is less than vp. In a non-dispersive medium, this is the equation. Vg is equal to Vp minus lambda dVp by d lambda. In a non-dispersive medium, such as empty space, say omega by k is constant. Omega by k is constant. It's equal to Vp. If it is constant, so dVp by d lambda is equal to 0. As dvp by d lambda means dvp by d lambda means d by d lambda omega by k. Omega means 2 pi nu. Nu can be represented in terms of lambda. K is also 2 pi by lambda. So changing this, dvp by d lambda becomes 0 as it is a constant. Omega by k means dvp by d lambda is constant. This is a constant. Anything differentiated with respect to lambda, a constant, it becomes 0. So vg is equal to, if it is a constant, it becomes 0, so Vg is equal to Vp. For non-dispersive medium, group velocity is equal to phase velocity. But for dispersive medium, Vg is, almost all cases, Vg is less than Vp. Phase velocity of de Broglie's waves. According to de Broglie's hypothesis of matter waves, lambda is equal to h by mv. Wave number k is equal to 2 pi by lambda. Now lambda is equal to, putting lambda is equal to h by mv, this becomes h, this mv. So k is equal to 2 pi mv by h. If a particle has energy e, then corresponding wave will have frequency nu is equal to E by H. As E is equal to H nu, so nu is equal to E by H. Then angular frequency will be, omega means 2 pi nu, nu means H by E by H, so 2 pi E by H. So omega is equal to, this is omega, is equal to 2 pi E by H. So we have to put E is equal to mc square. So this is 2 pi mc square by h. So omega by k is equal to 2 pi mc square by h. K means, 1 by k means h by 2 pi mv. As k is equal to 2 pi mv by h. 2 pi mv by h. So this omega by k means phase velocity vp. So this is equal to 2 pi m, 2 pi m will cancel out, hh will cancel out. So this is becomes c square by v. So vp is equal to c square by v. But v is always velocity. This velocity is less than the velocity of light. So velocity of de Broglie waves, vp, is always greater than c, which is not acceptable. De Broglie waves will move faster than the particle velocity. This is the particle velocity. And hence, the waves would left the particle behind. De Broglie waves will move faster than the particle velocity. Hence, the waves would left behind the particle. Waves will move faster than the particle. Group velocity of de Broglie's waves. The discrepancy is resolved by postulating that a moving particle is associated with a wave packet or wave group rather than a single wave train. A wave group having wavelength lambda is composed of a number of component waves with slightly different wavelengths in the neighborhood of lambda. Consider a particle of rest mass is m0 and it is moving with a velocity of v. Then the associated matter wave will have omega is equal to 2 pi mc square by h and k is equal to 2 pi mv by h. That is already we have done here. This is k 2 pi mv by h and omega is equal to 2 pi mc square by h. For m is equal to, this is the Einstein's relativistic mass, m is equal to m0 root over 1 minus v square by c square, or v square, the v is the velocity of the particle. So omega is equal to 2 pi, changing this m by the relativistic mass, m0 root over m0 by root over 1 minus v square by c square, and k is equal to same, this m0 is changed, 2 pi m0 v by h root over 1 minus v square by c square. Now differentiating with respect to v, d omega by dv, d omega by dv becomes 2 pi m0 v by h 1 minus v square by c square to the power 3 by 2, and dk by dv is 2 pi m0 h 1 minus v square by c square to the power 3 by 2. So these are the d omega by dv and dk by dv. These are the two relations. So dividing 1 by 2 d omega by dv into dv by dk, so d omega by dk becomes 2 pi m0 v by 2 pi m0. This becomes v. V is the particle velocity. So group velocity, this is the group velocity, this one becomes particle velocity. So group velocity is equal to the particle velocity. Wave group associated with a moving particle also moves with the velocity of the particle. Wave group associated with a particle also moved with the velocity of the particle. So moving particle is equal to wave packet or wave group.